Welcome back. Today we are going to study about specific energy and its effect in uniform flow. So moving ahead, we can see what is specific energy. Basically, from Bernoulli's equation, we have studied that in any flow, total energy consists of pressure energy or potential energy, kinetic energy and its datum energy. And Bernoulli stated that energy or summation of all these energy or total energy remains constant, right? So, if we focus on specific energy, on the term specific energy, let me take the marker. On the term specific energy, then we can see that, like suppose this is the channel and its datum, bed of the channel, and this is datum. You are having certain depth y and then that elongation, right? Or you can say this is datum z, this is your value y, depth, and this is the drop down in the energy line. Right. So, according to Bernoulli's, what we have studied, total energy is what? Total energy attained will be summation of datum head, potential head plus kinetic head. Right. This is the equation for total energy given by Bernoulli's. But what does the specific energy say? Specific energy says if we considered channel bottom and datum coinciding with each other, that is if both of these line, like this line that is datum and this is channel bed, they coincide with each other like this, that is there is no existence of datum, then the remaining portion will be termed it to as specific energy. That is, if we do not consider this point, the remaining section will be termed as specific energy. Or you can say if specific energy is being represented by E, then it consists of y plus v square upon 2g, right? And from here we can conclude that y is nothing but potential energy. Is that? And v square 2 by 2g is nothing but kinetic energy, giving us an idea that is specific energy is comprising of potential energy plus kinetic energy, right? Although specific energy keeps on reducing, it may increase, it may decrease based on the elevation of this surface, it keeps on changing, but it behaves as uniform taking datum as 0, right? In the next one, we can see that equation of specific energy for rectangular section can be in different form. It can be noted like as a point to remember, you can say specific energy's equation what we have studied v square upon 2g, reason being from total equation, from total energy equation by Bernoulli's, if we deteriorate or if we eliminate datum value, what we are getting is represented as specific energy, or specific means particular energy, and particular condition is what you need to deteriorate, you need to remove the existence of datum. For rectangular channel, this is a note for rectangular channel, we will be converting this one, like Q is equal to what? A into V, and area for channel, rectangular channel will be B into Y Q, or you can say capital Q, that is discharge per unit width will be equivalent to depth into velocity, and this discharge per unit width is being represented by small q is equivalent to y into v, or you can say V equivalent to Q by Y, right? This is the value we have got for rectangle section, right? And if we are substituting the value of this V in the main equation, what we are getting it as E equivalent to Y plus. What is the value of V? Q by Y, and V square will be Q square by Y square, and remaining parameters will be 2G. So, you can see that for rectangular section, energy can be written it as this one. For rectangular section, E can be written it as Y plus small q square upon 2G Y square. Is that? Here you can see, either in case of potential energy or in case of kinetic energy, you can see in both the terms you have certain depth and certain depth, and both of them comprises addition of them will be giving you specific energy. This is what we have written for rectangular section. You can say Q, that is discharge, is equivalent to cross sectional area into velocity. Further same from here, taking the value of V and substituting in this one, what we are getting it as E equals to Q plus discharge, square root of discharge per unit width by 2G Y square, right? Now, this was a briefing about specific energy or the role of specific energy. Now, we can study about the specific energy curve. Specific energy curve means you need to have two parameters to plot a curve. So, for this the one which is known for specific energy curve will be E and Y, that is specific energy versus depth. So, here we are going to plot a graph between E and Y, right? Basic equation, you took it as E equivalent to Y plus Q square upon 2G Y square, right? So, let us begin. This is your Y along Y axis and E along X axis, right? You can see E equal to Y. E is directly proportional to Y, means it is having a linear relationship. Let us draw a linear line from the origin, that is this one, E equals to EP, this EP equal to Y, this is potential energy, making an angle of 45 degree with each of the axes, X axis and Y axis. Next one, you can see E and Y, it will be having parabolic relationship because it is having in square, so we can draw one parabola, right? This will be giving you EK will be equivalent to V square upon 2G, or further you can write it as Q square upon 2G Y square, right? This we have drawn this plot separately for potential energy and kinetic energy. Now, what is specific energy? Specific energy is the summation of potential energy and kinetic energy. So, we need to plot one graph which results in the summation of this line and this one. So, what we can do for plotting specific energy, we can draw a graph like a bit of it could be met over here, and this will be the resultant one, and in that resultant one you can notice at the point of intersection, at the point of intersection of depth of potential energy and depth of kinetic energy, there will be a meeting point of energy, and this will be terming it to as E minimum. Reason being, specific energy as minimum, reason being this intersection depicts, this is the minimum value you are getting to make the flow happen. YC, that is critical depth. This is the critical depth at the intersection of both, means certain amount of depth is required to initiate potential energy and kinetic energy and summation of both should have a common value of depth, and that is Yc, and this Yc means critical depth. Wherever this critical depth is meeting on the specific energy curve, let me write it, specific energy curve, this is E equivalent to Ep plus Ek, or you can say this one, this value only, and this value will be giving you E minimum. Another noticeable thing is, now just see, if this is the critical depth, if this is the critical depth, means this line passing through critical depth will be critical depth flow, critical flow. In this particular section, you can see that this is critical flow. Critical flow will happen over here. At critical depth, there will be critical flow, and above that, you can see that this will be subcritical, and this will be supercritical. Right? To remember this supercritical section and subcritical section, let us segregate it. Critical means what? Minimum. Critical means minimum condition. Then supercritical means super minimum, a value, a condition that is less than the minimum value, means this value will be lying downwards, and subcritical means a section of critical, that is the above value, right? For critical flow, we already know Fr is equivalent to 1, right? For supercritical, Fr is greater than 1, and for subcritical, it is Fr is less than 1. This is the condition. Now, if we focus on the graph attained on specific energy curve, like this one which we have drawn with the green color, specific energy curve, here you can say a point other than minimum specific energy, other than this point, you can see everywhere on the plot, everywhere on the plot, wherever you want to see, two different depths are giving a constant specific energy. Like if you draw this one, if you draw a line over here, you can see this value and this value. Let us change the color of the pen so that you can distinguish it easily. This point, you can say black one, it is having a point, a depth of y1, let us suppose, and a point this one, let us suppose this is y2, all right, and it is giving you a specific energy E. Now, you yourself can see, and you can plot it anywhere on the curve. Specific energy curve depicts what? Any point other than minimum specific energy. It has a single specific energy, has two different depth. One depth is in supercritical section, other depth is in subcritical section. That is, one will be less than critical depth Yc, other will be greater than critical depth Yc. And these depth are known as alternate depth. Alternate depth, and these depth are known as alternate depth. So, you can summarize it all, like basically 5 points are there to be pondered in specific energy curve, like the primary equation for plotting specific energy curve, that is E versus depth, is this one, and in that first you can draw separately E versus Ep and E versus Ek, that is specific energy versus potential energy and specific energy versus kinetic energy, and then you can do the addition and then can plot a summarized form, and in the summarized form you can notice there will be a point joining the intersection of both of them, will be terming it to as critical depth, and the specific energy attained at critical depth can be termed as minimum specific energy. And the last point is, any point other than minimum specific energy will be possessing two types of depth known as alternate depth. And those depth will be, one will be less than critical depth, other will be greater than critical depth. That is, one will be lying in supercritical section and other will be lying in subcritical section. That's all you can say. This was the final plot. I included it just to make sure you remember each point while we were drawing at that time. E, this is E x axis, we have kept E specific energy, y axis we have kept depth, right? And you can see first we have drawn this E p, then E k, then we have summarized this one, and there you can say at the intersection of them lies the critical depth, and other than this at the critical depth lies the E minimum value. You can attain E minimum value. Other than this, you can see all the points wherever you can draw, it is having two alternate depths, and they are like they have given H1 and H2, representation is different. You can say Y1 and Y2 also, they are alternate depth, and one is lying in supercritical zone, other one is lying in subcritical zone. Now, coming to the concept of critical depth. So, as we have already seen in our graph of specific energy versus depth, that critical depth is nothing but a point where specific energy is minimum, right? Or you can say critical depth is being attained in critical flow, and critical flow is being attained where Froude's number is 1. Now, what is Froude's number? Froude's number is nothing but what you are up to is this. So, you can say if y will be fr is equivalent to 1, you are having what? Critical depth. Now, the two zones are remaining, subcritical depth and supercritical depth, or subcritical flow, supercritical flow, wherein you can see for the subcritical flow, fr should be less than 1, and it is also known as tranquil or streaming flow, if asked ever in any of the papers. Supercritical flow is greater than fr is greater than 1, and it is also known as shooting flow. This is the concept of critical depth actually, and critical flow, or the point where critical flow is moving on, we need to know the critical depth, critical velocity, all the critical parameter, discharge, critical area, top width, and everything, wherever critical depth is having. Now, we can move on the next section, critical velocity. So, as I have already told, critical velocity is nothing but the velocity attained in critical flow at critical depth, right? So, at critical flow means what? Fr equals to 1. At critical flow means what? Fr equals to 1. And what is Fr? Now, here you can say Fr equals to 1 is where? Wherever there is a critical flow, right? At critical flow, Fr equals to 1, and all the parameters at critical flow can be termed as or denoted in suffix as C. Then this V velocity will be changing to Vc, and Y will be changing to Yc, or you can say critical velocity will be equivalent to under root of the product of G and Yc. This is what we have attained, the similar pattern, that is if we need to calculate the critical velocity, you need to have the square root and their product of G and Yc. You need to calculate Yc for different shapes, that is rectangular, triangular, trapezoidal, even circular. So, that is all we have studied today about the specific energy. Specific energy is nothing but in the total energy equation, if we consider that channel bottom and datum are coinciding with each other, or they do not exist, or if we neglect datum, then the remaining section will be termed as specific energy. Then we have studied about the graph of specific energy versus depth, then critical concept, critical flow concept, under it critical depth, then critical velocity. In our next section, we will be studying about the uniform flow in open channels, Chasse's equation or its basic equations. That's all for today. Thank you.